Hello all, my name is Ashutosh Rastogi. I am a teacher by profession. My mission is to impart quality education for all. For that purpose, I am creating these videos. If you appreciate my work, then please do like my video and subscribe my channel so that I could get the motivation to prepare more videos. Anyways, today in this particular lecture, we are going to discuss about the various generation mechanism of your AM signal, such as your square law modulator and your switching modulator. So these are the outlines. We are going to start up with the introduction. Then we'll going to discuss about your various AM generation mechanism. First, we'll going to discuss about your square law modulator, and then we'll going to discuss about your switching modulator. So in our last lecture, we have discussed about the mathematical analysis of your AM signal, of complex message signal, or you could say your multitonic message signal. Then we have seen an AM signal consists of three components, such as your carrier signal, upper sideband, as well as your lower sideband. So these are three constituents of your traditional AM signal, that it will going to contain three components. Then in this particular lecture, we will going to focus on how we actually going to generate your traditional AM signal. So there are basically two methods. So the circuit that generates the AM wave is called the amplitude modulator. And what are two different AM modulator available is, that is your square law modulator and your switching modulator. So we'll going to take up both of them one by one. So both of these circuits use a non-linear element such as a diode for their implementation. So both these modulators are your low power modulator circuits, that is, we will going to modulate our signal when they are at low power level, and then after modulation we will going to apply them to your amplifier, which will going to further power modulate them. Or you could say that further your amplifier circuitry will going to increase the power of your modulated signal so that they can further be transported to the longer distances. So this particular figure is basically showing your square law modulator. Here we will be having two input signal. One is your carrier signal, which is denoted by your AC cos of omega CT, where omega C is the angular carrier frequency, whose linear carrier frequency is turns out to be your FC. So omega C is nothing but that will be equivalent to your 2 pi FC. MT is nothing but your sinusoidal message signal, or the signal that you want to modulate. And the combination of both two signals, that is your carrier signal as well as your message signal, or you could say your modulating signal, we will going to apply them to your non-linear device, which is nothing but your diode circuitry or your transistor. So any device which is performing or having this non-linear characteristics, that could have been used in place of your non-linear device. And then this combined signal would have been passed through your tuned circuitry, or you could say your band pass filter. Then after proper filtering, we can have our AM modulated waveform, which will going to contain all three components, that is your upper sideband, your lower sideband, along with your carrier signal. So this is the description of the circuit that we have seen in our earlier slide. So let the modulating signal and the carrier signal be denoted as your MT, as we have discussed, and your AC cos of 2 pi FCT respectively. So these two signals are applied as the input to the non-linear device, which could be your transistor or your diode. For simplicity, we are assuming that your non-linear device is your diode and it is operating in your non-linear region. So mathematically, we can write the input to the non-linear device as V1t will be equal to MT plus AC cos of 2 pi FCT, as it has been shown in your earlier figure. So here Vt is nothing but it is the combination of both of these two signals, that is, we will going to pass this particular signal through a summer, or you could say your combined V1t signal is nothing but it is the summation of both these two signals. Then the diode resistor equation is given as, obviously, since we are assuming your nonlinear characteristics, so your V2t, or you could say the outcome of your nonlinear device, would have been given as A1V1t plus A2V1 square t. So where this your A1 and A2 are the constant. So this is the general equation of your any nonlinear device. It is basically representing its input-output relationship. So here V2t is your output voltage and V1t is the applied input voltage to your nonlinear device. So since the diode here, it is a nonlinear device, hence its output voltage can be given as, obviously here we are assuming that, or we are basically doing such biasing to our diode so that it may be operating in your nonlinear region. So V2t can be given as your A1 times of V1t plus A2 times of V1 square t.
So where v1t is equal to mt plus ac cos of omega ct, that is, it is nothing but the addition or summation of both of these two signals, that is your message signal and your carrier signal. So v2t can be further expanded with this particular thing, that is a1 times of mt plus ac cos of omega ct plus a2 times of mt plus ac cos of omega ct square. So we have done nothing here, we just have to put in this particular equation v1t is equal to mt plus ac cos of omega ct. So what we are left with this particular thing, and then what we have do is we have just expanded this whole square term, and we have collected the specific components. So we are left with your a1 times of ac times of 1 plus 2a2 upon a1 mt times of cos of omega ct plus a1 times of mt plus a2 m square t plus a2 ac square cos square omega ct. You just can simply compare that we have opened this whole square term, that is your a plus b whole square, that will be equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So we have applied this particular formula and we are having this particular equation. So the first term is the desired AM waveform with amplitude sensitivity, that would have been given as your 2a2 times of a1. So remaining unwanted three terms are removed by appropriate filtering. So if we closely observe that this particular term a1 times of mt plus a2 times of m square t plus a2 ac square cos square omega ct. So these three terms, that is first, second and third, these three terms are your unwanted signal, or you could say they are basically translated to your those frequency component which are undesired. And if you closely observe that this particular signal is your desirable frequency signal, or you could say your AM signal. So if in this particular signal, if we are going to apply proper band pass filtering, or if we going to perform some proper filtering which will going to avoid all three components, and we are left with this particular component which is nothing but your AM signal. So this is how, with the help of square law modulator, we are in a state to create our AM signal. So now next mechanism by which we can produce our AM signal is your switching modulator. So this particular figure is basically representing the block diagram structure of your switching modulator. So here again, we will again going to have these two signals. Number one is your message signal, which is denoted by this your MT. And second one is your carrier signal, which is denoted by your AC times of cos of omega CT. And this combined signal would have been applied to this diode. Or here this diode is basically acting as your ideal switching circuit. So this particular signal will going to pass through your band pass filtering, and we are having this type of outcome, that is equivalent to your k1 times of cos of omega ct plus k2 times of mt cos of omega ct. So mathematically, obviously, we have to look it out that what actual signal we will going to get at the output, which is equivalent to your AM signal, and how it is at. For that particular thing, we have to perform some mathematical analysis. So switching modulator is similar to your square law modulator, except the major difference is here diode has to operate as an ideal switch in your switching modulator, whereas in your square law modulator that diode is acting as your non-linear device. But here in this particular case, your diode is acting as your switching, or you could say ideal switch circuit. So the input voltage to the diode is nothing but it is the combination of both your message signal as well as your carrier signal. So V1T is nothing but it is the input of your diode circuitry, which is equal to MT plus AC times of cos of omega CT. Here we are assuming that MT, or you could say your message signal, is very much less than your AC. Or you could say the peak amplitude of your message signal is very much less than the peak amplitude of your carrier signal. So here we can say that V2 will be equal to V1T when CT is greater than 0, and it is equal to 0 when CT is less than 0. Since it is operating a specific switching circuitry, so what we are left with, if diode is in your forward bias, then at the output we will be having this V1T, and if it is your reverse bias, then in this particular case the output signal will be your 0, or you could say in this particular case your diode is in your non-conducting state, whereas in the first step you could say diode is acting as your conducting state. So VT can be further be expressed as V2T will be equal to the summation of these two signals, that is your V1 times of GPT, where this GPT is basically representing a kind of pulsating signal which would have been given by this particular figure. So what is so peculiar about this your GPT or this particular pulse is, if we closely observe our your carrier signal, so the frequency of carrier signal is much higher. So for the half of the carrier cycle, your diode is in your conducting state, and for half of the cycle, diode is in your non-conducting state. This particular square waveform is basically showing that in this particular region, your diode is in your conducting state, and this off state is basically representing your diode's non-conducting state. So we could easily say that V2 can be represented with the product of these two terms. So here this your minus T0 by 4 to plus T0 upon 4. So this particular region, that is T0 upon 2 duration, your diode is acting as your conducting state. And this another half cycle, or you could say your T0 upon 2 time duration, the diode is acting as your non-conducting state. So GPT can be expanded as 1 upon 2 plus 2 upon pi cos of omega ct minus 1 upon 3 cos of 3 omega ct plus 1 upon 5 cos of 5 omega ct minus up to infinite term. So we have just expanded this square pulse with the help of this Fourier series expansion. So here it is basically having this cosinusoidal term only, and one is your DC term. So V2t can be further given as your MT plus AC cos of omega CT, and instead of your GPT, we have put this particular thing. So what we are left with is your MT upon 2 plus AC upon 2 cos of omega CT plus 2 upon pi MT times of cos omega CT up to infinite term, or whatever terms we will going to take. So these are basically representing your omega CT, 3 omega CT, 5 omega CT. They are basically representing their higher order harmonics terms. So when we will going to pass this particular signal via proper filter, then we are in a state to have your AM signal. So if we closely observe this particular block diagram structure, where the outcome of this band pass filter is of type K1 times of cos of omega CT plus K2 times of MT cos of omega CT. So what are they? So the desired components are your AC upon 2 cos of omega CT, which is nothing but your carrier component, plus 2 upon pi MT times of cos of omega CT, which is nothing but it is showing your double sideband, or you could say your upper sideband as well as your lower sideband. So these are your desirable component. So if we compare with this particular outcome structure, we are left with here K1 is equal to AC upon 2 and K2 is equal to 2 upon pi. So this is how, with the help of your switching modulator, we will going to generate your AM modulated waveform, which will going to have all three components, that is your carrier signal, and this is the combined signal of your upper sideband as well as your lower sideband, or you could say it is your DSB-SC signal if we are only talking about this particular thing. So DSB-SC signal plus your carrier signal, it is nothing but your traditional AM signal. So this is how, with the help of switching modulator, we will going to generate your traditional AM signal. So hopefully you guys have got the insight that how, with the help of these two mechanisms, we will going to generate our traditional AM signal. In case of any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll try to solve them out as soon as possible. So these are the references. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.